Lukas Carey, head coach of the Bendigo Lady Braves. Thanks for joining us.
No problems, Ed. Thank you.
Lukas, a lot to talk about, I guess, starting with the changes to your lineup. Players coming in like Renee Camino, Mia Newley, Kieran Harrington. It's almost, just to name a few, it's almost like an entirely new team for you guys.
Well, obviously we've had to make some changes. We have done so. You know, losing players, you know, similar to Kelly and Lauren King and those sort of guys is going to be a loss for us, but we feel pretty good about what we've been able to put on the floor. We've got a group that has more country Victorian kids in it than we've ever had before, and we've got a group that's had more Bendigo juniors in it than I can remember. So, you know, there's some real positives for us in that way.
Talk to us about that reasoning behind some of the decisions you had to make, because it didn't seem like you were that far off a championship, but, you know, you've gone and got more Bendigo juniors in there. Was that primarily the reason for the changes?
No, I think, you know, there's obviously a few reasons to it, you know, but definitely opportunities for people. You know, obviously losing Kelly and Lauren are huge holes, you know, but also losing Tony Edmondson to the Olympics, Heather Oliver, Andrea Wilson, and also Ash Gilmore to another sport, you know, playing netball now, and then Megan Moody, who's taken over as coaching the D-League team for us this year, and he's doing some great things with the kids. So, yes, it's painful and tough on one avenue, but it's also very, very positive on the other way.
With so many new players coming into the team, how are you looking at this year? Are you just trying to get the group to gel and blend together? Are you at risk of going backwards instead of forward with so many changes?
If I had a crystal ball, I could answer that question. But, you know, what we've done is we're happy with the group we've put together. You know, we targeted some key areas, and we've met most of those targets, and we've achieved a lot of those targets. Obviously, bringing in, you know, Renee and Mia are two of our big ones. You know, bringing Karen back to the club is fantastic. As a Bendigo junior, having players like Lucy Spalding, who is another Bendigo junior, return, you know, keeping you know, Jane Chalmers and Sarah Strange, and then pairing them with some new kids, you know, some people that, yes, they might have played WNBL or they might have been involved in National League, but they got a lot of extra positives they bring to the floor.
Mate, you made it to the second round of the playoffs last year, you know, only falling to Kilsyth. Have you identified one or two areas that, you know, you need to improve on to go a step further this year?
Probably two things mainly. Number one was our consistent defensive intensity. You know, we didn't have a problem putting up points. You know, the amount of games we lost by scoring 85 or 86 points was a big difference between us literally finishing the top couple compared to finishing third or fourth. You know, you don't want to say results are different if you win a couple of extra games, but yeah, that's probably the one bit. Second bit would be probably the ability for people to share the ball, and that's something that we think we need to look at again, and that's what, you know, where we're going this year, is that we're going to have a lot of people that are going to move the ball on, and we're going to be able to sort of, I suppose, you know, make sure that we actually sort of put offences to bed, you know, to be able to actually run sets, to get through things and really make sure that we get everyone a chance to play.
Okay, mate, well, certainly plenty of changes afoot, but at the same time plenty to look forward to for yourself and for the Lady Braves this year. Good luck this year, and thanks for your time today.
Anytime, mate. Thank you very much.